Hi, teacher.
Hi. How are you?
Hey, teacher. Hoy no me estar preguntando mucho. Y...
Why not?
Me fui a poner la vacuna, la AstraZeneca, y ando
acabado.
Y es que no siento ningún dolor, no siento dolor.
Solo es como debilidad, sueño.
Un hostigamiento. Estoy como que anduviera de goma, estoy tomando agua helada.
Sí. Yo mañana me voy a poner, pero la segunda dosis. De
la segunda.
De hecho, el martes me tocaba, pero últimamente he andado con fuerte dolor de cabeza. Y me han dicho varios amigos que no me la voy a poner así, porque ellos cometieron ese error de que andaban con dolor de cabeza y se la fueron a poner y los dobló. Ya me pasaron como 3 días en cama, entonces me dijeron, para que no te pase lo mismo, espera que te pase el dolor y luego vas. So, tomorrow I'm going. Así que ojalá que...
Okay.
Ya, pues.
Sí, ojalá.
Lo que he estado viendo es que sí, la tercera dosis, a casi todos los que conozco que se la han puesto, han sufrido efectos. Inclusive los que no sufrieron efectos en la primera y segunda dosis. Ya, yeah, means.
Sí,
de
hecho, yo cansado. Casi no... La primera y segunda dosis no tuve mayor cosa. La primera vez que me lo pusieron, quiero ver qué fue. Sueño me dio, y lo mismo me dio. Lo mismo que ando ahorita, sueño, y como que andaba de goma. La segunda dosis me dio náusea.
Ajá.
Me dio náusea, pasé como dos o tres días con náusea.
Ajá.
Y esta ahorita me ha dado sueño, me siento incómodo. Pero no me ha dado ni temperatura, no.
Ajá, simplemente
nada,
es,
o sea,
you know, like, es el decaimiento. That's what you have, right? Yeah, I mean, that happens.
Es que se le escucha cortado, teacher.
Probablemente, no sé ahora si me escucha bien.
Ahora sí.
Sí, es que tenía medio mal el micrófono. No, y otra cosa que acá está cayendo una fuerte tormenta también. Espero no vayamos a tener problemas con la señal. Yeah, I mean, it is raining hard today, not tonight.
Ojalá que no.
Ajá, ojalá que no. So let's see, more people are getting connected. So what's up with the crypto money, Eric? Have you downloaded the application?
So, perdón.
Have you downloaded the application from crypto money? I mean, you know that Bitcoin thing.
Yes. Some 50 days before.
Ah, really?
Really.
Have you played with that app?
Le escuché cortado.
Have you played with that app?
Solo le escuché app y how al inicio.
Have you played with that app?
No. It was just, really just, no.
It was just to download the money.
No, fíjense que yo la descargué para probarla y hice un par de hice transacciones, estuve así quizás como una semana.
Ya.
Luego me aburrí y se los transferí a mi hija.
Ajá.
De ahí mi hija dijo, no, con eso vamos a pagar el súper. Entonces ya tenía 60 y pico él. Y hoy los últimos 30 y pico que quedaban. Dijimos, el domingo nos fuimos a desayunar ahí a la Pizza Hut. Me fueron 31 me fue en desayuno. No. Así que ahí no lo acabamos. Pero ya, estuve jugando, sí. Ahorita ya tengo ahí como unos 5, creo, otra vez.
Muy cool, está
bueno. Más o menos. Esa es práctica, en algunos casos es práctica.
Yeah, I mean, it's like kind of practical, as you know, as you say. Yeah. It's just to play around with that. At least you know people are getting connected. Let's see how many we have. Can you say that again? Okay. Good. Let's start. Since, you know, today is basically the last video conference from week 3. Today we finished with week 3, just one more week, and we basically finish the module. I mean, the time flies. El tiempo va super rápido, ya básicamente nos falta una semana a partir de mañana. So, el próximo miércoles básicamente estaríamos finalizando con el módulo y no surge ningún inconveniente. And that's pretty cool. That's pretty nice. Check. I'm going to start with the attendance list because we have a lot of information to share today. Okay, if you don't listen to me, please let me know because I think the internet is like not working properly. And besides that, it is raining here. So I don't listen that much. But let's start with the attendance list. We got Ana Claribel, she's not here. Ana Maria, another. Carlos Ademir, Carlos, Eric Guillermo.
Present, teacher.
Okay, good. Ever de Jesus.
Present.
Okay, good. Then we got Fatima Alejandra. Fatima, so here. Hilmar Cruz. Hilmar got late today. Jonathan Alexander, Jonathan is not here. Jorge Elvir, a lot of people is not here. Carla Benazir. Carla. Hello, Carla, are you there? Carla, do you listen to me? All right, I think she has issues with the audio. Let's fix that, Carla. I know you're there, but I think you have problems with the audio, right? Okay, let's see. Margot Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Ah, okay, good. We got Maritza Alcira.
Good evening, buena, I'm here, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Natalie Vanessa. It's not here yet, right? Romeo Alexis.
Present.
Okay. Rosa del Carmen. Rosa, are you there? Rosa. Okay, I think she's not there.
Present.
Ah, okay, you're there. Ruth Joanna.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Sara Carolina. Let me check. This is... not here. Right? All right. Stephanie Lissette. No, she's not here yet. Vanessa Odette. All right, neither her. Then we got William Alberto.
Present.
Ah, okay, very good. Thank you, William.
Good.
All right, just give me a second. I'm gonna face. All right, Carla. What you do is like you can try on in the microphone option. Voy a hacer las opciones de audio en la parte donde aparece el pequeño micrófono, okay. Si no le aparece así, lo que puede hacer es like, desconectar la sesión y vuelva a conectar. Probably that will fix the problem. All right, Roxana Yesenia.
Present, teacher.
Ah, okay. Nubia Zulema. Nubia, are you there? Okay. Jennifer Noemi.
Present.
Ah, okay. Then we got Diana Gabriela. All right, but I think Diana is not there. Okay, so we are going to start with the Ami. Yes, like Hilmar is here. Late, but here. Give me a second, I'm gonna put it. Okay, there you go. So let's start with the information that we have for today, people. Today we're gonna have a very interesting topic. Actually not topic, it's just a feedback from all the topics that we have been discussing during the week. All right, it's going to be kind of easy for you because those structures were the ones that we were practicing with questions and answers, right? Positive statements and negative statements using the simple past. Let's remember that all this week was based in simple past, the structure of simple past. And if you remember, we started with the verb be, and right after the verb be, we were working with other examples, like using be. So, let's give me a second. I'm going to share the presentation that we are going to have today or tonight. There you go. So this is the video conference 15. As I told you, we finish week number 3 today. So basically tomorrow we start week number 4. All right. And we finish basically in seven days. So what we got for today is just the simple past review and practice, right? Today, what we're going to do is just to make a general review from all the structures that we were practicing in simple past. And besides the review, we are going to start practicing some exercises. Okay, so what do we have for this class? Like the main points that we got for the whole class. As I told you, what we're going to do is use the general review or feedback from the previous topics. Okay. Right after that, we are going to provide examples for every specific topic. After the examples, we are going to do some exercises. Just remember, we are going to do some kind of exercises. And then we are going to end up with some exercises in the manual. We got to work in the manual, all right? So this is basically what we have for the class of today. Let's remember, if you have any questions related to the structures that we are about to give a feedback, just turn on the microphone and let me know, okay? So in that way, we can clarify any question or any idea that you can have. So let's continue. Okay, listen. This is just a model of examples, right? If you remember, we started the uses of the simple past of the verb be in class number 11, okay? And we were saying that the simple past of be have two forms. One of them is was, and the second one is were, right? Was and were. Those are like the two forms of the verb be in simple past. All right, when do we use them? We got the structure in here, okay? And check this out. We are going to start with was, okay? Jonathan, help me a reading.
Singular noun.
Okay. Let's see. Listen. We use was with I, okay? He, she, it, and singular nouns. Let's remember, when we say singular nouns, is when we mention only one person, one place, one object, or one animal, okay? One animal. Example, the cat was on the window. So in that case, we're talking about only one animal, right? Okay, so let's see a couple of examples. And of course, we are going to give our own. This is the example number one. Romeo, help me out reading.
I was in the party last night.
Okay. Good, Romeo. I was in the party last night. So you see, we use was because we are talking in first person. In this case, I'm talking about myself, right? In a party. Okay, the second example. Let's see who can help me out reading the second example. Ruth, help me out reading the second example, please.
He was a member from that company.
All right, thank you, Ruth. So we got, he was a member from that company. Why do we have was in that case? Let's remember, because it's only one person that we are talking about, okay? Only one person, that's why we use was. And let's remember another thing. Recordemos otra cosa. Cuando usamos la forma del verbo to be was o were, cuando hablamos en plurales, no usamos ningún otro verbo aparte de was o were, okay? No debemos utilizar un verbo que indique acción, okay? Extra. ¿Por qué? Porque entonces no sería la forma pasada del verbo to be.
Verbo to be.
Exactly. Ya estaríamos hablando de pasado progresivo, que esa es otra estructura. Okay? So let's keep that on mind. Así que tengan en cuenta eso, de que no vamos a utilizar otro verbo adicional, okay? Simplemente vamos a utilizar was o were, okay? All right. Let's see the next example. William, help me out reading.
Okay, she was the oldest
of the computer.
All right. She was the owner of the computer. Do you know what is owner? What does owner mean in Spanish? What is owner?
Dueña o dueño.
Hey, there you go. Owner means dueña o dueño, okay? Cuando hablamos sobre quién le pertenece a un objeto.
Good evening,
Jorge. Okay, so let's continue. Okay, Jennifer, help me reading this example.
Carla was part of the team.
Okay. Carla was part of the team. So you see, it was like, ah, Carla era parte del, del equipo. Okay. So you see, in there, we don't use an extra verb. Why? Because it is not possible that we can keep or we can put an extra verb in there, right? You can add an adjective, you can add a proper noun, you can add something else, but you cannot add an extra verb, okay? Let's remember that. So basically, this is like related to the uses of was. Recordemos, este nada más es para el uso de was, okay? Only for was. In what way? Ah, en oraciones positivas. Let's remember, positive statements using was. When do we use was? Ah, we use it with I, he, she, it, or singular nouns, okay? With five different positions or of subjects. In this case, okay. So let's see if we have understood. Let's do one example, okay? No necesiten, no, creo que no, no van a necesitar de estarlo anotando, okay? Let's keep it by your own. My example, it will be, I was, listen, I was in the office today morning. I was in the office today morning. Stop, it's like, estaba en la oficina este día por la mañana. So you see, I am expressing something in simple past using was. Ahora bien, quiero que me regalen un ejemplo ustedes sin necesidad de escribirlo, right? Quiero que me regalen un ejemplo usando was, ya sea en primera persona con I o tercera persona usando he or she, okay? When you got something in your head, let me know, okay? And you can read your example. So let's see if you have understood that part. Let's do one example. And when you finish the example, just let me know, okay, and read the example.
Teacher.
Yes.
For example, I was taking today one test. No.
No, porque lleva el verbo take con ing. Y recuerde que cuando usamos el verbo to be, no debemos usar otro verbo adicional. Porque el verbo to be tiene que indicar acción.
Oh.
Yes. Okay. Sir. Ajá.
She was in the gym
every night.
Every night. Okay. All right. That one is correct, right? She was in the gym every night. Okay. You don't have an extra verb in there. Let's remember. Okay. Who else got the example? Who else has the example?
Teacher.
Uh-huh.
I was in the park the last weekend.
Okay, very good. I was in the park last weekend. Thank you, Evan. Who else got the example?
Hi, teacher.
Okay, Maritza, go.
I was in my house every day. Today.
Okay, today.
Mm-hmm. Today.
Today. There you go. I was in my house today. Okay. All right, Hilmar.
I was in the restaurant in the morning.
Okay, very good.
Number two, she was in the office yesterday.
Ah, okay. She was in the office yesterday. There you go. Thank you, William. I mean, Hilma. It's a mixed the names. Let's see. Who else has finished?
Teacher.
All right,
Eric. Teacher.
Okay, Eric and then Ruth.
Tengo una duda acá, por eso. I was at the vaccination center this afternoon.
I was
at the vaccination center this afternoon.
Ah, okay, very good. Yeah, that's correct. Thank you, Eric.
Okay, thank you.
All right, Ruth.
I was in the gym weekend.
Last weekend.
I was in the gym weekend.
Last weekend.
Last weekend.
El fin de semana pasado. Ah, entonces eso sería last weekend, okay?
Last weekend.
Okay, thank you, Rob. I was right. Okay, who else got the sentence?
Yo, teacher.
Okay, Fatima.
I was in the university last year.
Okay, you were at the university last year. Thank you, Fatima. That was correct. Who else has the sentence?
The weather was hot.
Ah, okay, very good. The weather was hot. Oh, it was hot. También se puede de esa manera. It was hot. Okay, there you go.
The weather was cool.
Aha. Okay.
Okay.
Very good. Thank you, William. So let's see who else is missing. Romeo, let's give me an example.
Okay. I was.
I was
little, slow. ¿Cómo se dice abajo? No, pequeño.
I was, but what you mean with that, Romeo?
Dígame.
¿Qué quería decir?
Yo era pequeño.
Ah, right. I was short.
¿Cómo?
I was short, or I was young, or I was little.
Okay,
very good. Somebody else? Let me see who's missing. Jennifer, let's give me an example.
I was very quiet at school.
I was quiet at school.
Okay.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Let's see. Rosa, let's give me an example.
I was in the job early.
Okay, I was in the job early. Very good. And Nubia, are you there, Nubia?
Teacher, I'll try again.
Okay, Jorge, let's go for it.
I remember the one song I like it so much is the I Was Made for Love You.
I was made for loving, to love you.
For loving you. It's not
all
correct?
Right. All right. Técnicamente está correcta, all right? There is no a problem, all right? In the structure, but related to the structure that we are practicing, it is not correct.
Why?
Because in that case, if you remember in module number 3, you with your previous teacher, were studying something that is called, or that was called in that moment, passive voice. Do you remember that topic from the past module? Passive
yes.
voice?
And later.
in which you used to have the verb be in is, are, and am. Okay, that one is passive voice using the verb be, but in simple past.
Okay.
Como dice, I was made. I was está correctamente posicionado, pero luego tiene el verbo que es made, que está en pasado participio. Entonces lleva dos verbos ahí, un verbo en pasado, que es okay. was, y un verbo en la tercera forma del pasado, que es pasado participio. Entonces, es como que fui hecho para amarte. Entonces ahí ya no estamos hablando de un pasado simple usando be, sino que ya estamos usando una estructura que se llama passive voice. All right.
Oh, okay, okay. Yes. But in another one, she was only 17. Is correct?
Yes, yeah, I mean, that one is correct. Uh-huh.
Okay, le pegué a dos a una, por lo menos, bye.
Yeah, I mean, the third one.
Gracias.
The third one. La tercera, okay, la vencida. So okay, good one. All right, nice. Carla, could you fix the problems with the audio? Nah, Carla, you didn't finish. You didn't solve the issue. Ooh, what will be the problem? Carla, si, simplemente diga sí o no. ¿Ha actualizado la versión de Zoom? Ah, you did it. But that's weird. ¿No será su audio, su conexión de audio?
Excuse me, teacher.
Yes.
A mí me pasó eso, lo que ayer o antier, y solo reinicié la computadora, la vieja confiable. Reinicié la computadora. Y luego vuelve a levantar el Zoom.
Yes, Carla, do it, porque sí necesitamos practicar, entonces necesito que ese micrófono esté funcionando, ¿ok? All right, let's do it, and then, like, enter again, ¿ok? Restart the computer. Okay, good. Let's see who's missing. Got Romeo, got Roxana, are you there? I need an example from you. I just see Roxana passing by there from one place to another.
Ay, teacher, es que estoy preparando la comida para mañana.
Ah, okay. You're a multitask person.
Pues sí, estoy escuchando la clase y cocinando y...
That's why I'm telling you, you are a multitask person right now.
Bueno, teacher, el ejemplo sería...
Ajá. Which one would
be? Estaba escuchando que no se puede colocar un verbo, ¿verdad, teacher?
Ajá. Only was.
Okay, entonces sería I was in happy in the in the iglesia.
In church.
I was happy in the church.
Ah, okay, very good. I was happy in the church, or I was happy in church. Okay, very good.
Okay, very teacher.
Good. Okay, thank you, Rosana. All right. I mean, Nubia apparently is connected, but she doesn't answer. Her video and audio doesn't work. Probably she got problems. But anyways, so let's continue. This one is just related to was, okay? Like, it was a good idea. Ah, fue una buena idea. Easy. We've got a simple past of be, but this case, let's use were, right? Fatima, help me out reading.
We use were with you, we, they, and plural nouns.
Ah, okay. Now, this is the other way around. Look, we use were with you, we, they and plural nouns. Let's remember, when we use plural nouns, it's like when we talk about more than one animal, more than one object, more than one place, more than one person, okay? Let's remember that. So we got a series of examples. Let's see. Ruth, help me out reading the example number one.
You were in your office yesterday.
Ah, okay, very good. You were in your office yesterday. So we're talking about a second person, right? Now, let's see. Margot, help me out reading the second example. Margot, are you there? Hello. Margot. Okay. All right. Ever, help me already, please.
We were excellent co-workers.
Okay, thank you. We were excellent co-workers. Let's remember, in that case, it's like when you are included in a group of people, okay? In that case, we use we, okay? So let's read the next one. Jorge.
They were in a different department.
Now, okay, very good. They were in a different department, right? Como ellos estaban o ellos eran de un departamento a diferente. Were inside the company, right? Dentro de la compañía. There you go. So basically, those are like the examples when we use were, okay? Now, how can we use were? Let's remember. With you, we, they, or plural nouns. What does plural noun mean? For example, if I say Hilmar and Ever were in their computers, okay? Hilmar and Ever estuvieron en sus computadoras. So you see, in that case, clear example of a plural. Si yo digo, my students, that is a plural version. I'm gonna write it down there. Give me a second. Check this out. My students. Since I say the word students, it means it's plural. My students were, okay, at the school, okay. My students were at the school, right? Or you can say, my students were in the video conference. Okay? My students were in the video conference. And that's still correct. Why? Because I am showing a plural form, okay? That one is a plural form. There you go. So this is part of what we have for it. So just let's remember. Okay, good. Let's continue. Give me a second, I'm going to erase that. And we can continue. All right, in here, let's remember, this was our simple past affirmative statements, okay? Affirmative statements. Now, let's jump into simple past, okay? Let me see. It's gonna be affirmative statements, okay? We've got some examples like I worked yesterday, you did the homework, she played soccer last week, okay? And all those things. Let me see, I'm gonna place them all. Now, listen, Acá ya básicamente no estamos hablando de las formas de verbo to be. ¿Qué estamos haciendo acá? Ah, in here we are talking about the simple past, but in a general way. How come? Aquí hablamos ya de una manera muy, muy general. Okay, sobre el uso del pasado. Why? Because in here we can use any verb you want. Porque acá podemos usar cualquier verbo que ustedes quieran, dependiendo de la acción que vamos a mencionar. All right? We got the example. But before the example, let's see. Vanessa, help me out reading the definition. From simple past. Vanessa? Okay, apparently she's not there. Eric, help me out reading, please.
He bought a television last week.
The definition, Eric.
Okay. Simple past. We use the simple past to talk about actions that started in the past and finished in the past.
Okay. So let's listen. We use the simple past to talk about actions that started in the past and finished in the past, okay? And they don't have any relevance in the simple present. We got examples. I worked yesterday, right? It's like trabajé ayer, okay? I gave these examples like a couple of days ago, if you remember, right? You did the homework, like, hiciste tu tarea, okay? O hiciste la tarea. There you go. That's an action in the past, right? She played soccer last weekend. It's like, ella jugó fútbol la semana pasada, el fin de semana pasado, okay? And then we got the last one. He bought a television last week. Okay, we got the word, the verb bought. Okay, remember, bought is the past form of the verb buy. Just keep that in mind, all right? Bought is the past form of the verb buy. Okay, let's continue with this. All right, simple past of be negative statements. But before going up into negative statements, pero antes de pasar a las formas negativas, okay, I want to see how well we are with this structure. I'm gonna give you here a couple of verbs. Like, I'm gonna use the verb go, do, okay, send, speak. We're going to use the verb buy, okay? We're going to use the verb work. We are going to use, let me see, the verb sleep, okay? And the last one, the verb practice. Okay. From here. Listen. What do I want with those verbs? ¿Qué quiero con esos verbos? Listen. Lo que quiero con esos verbos es que ustedes me escojan dos verbos de ahí. Dos verbos. Ok. Y con cada uno de esos verbos me escriban una oración. Listen. Una oración en primera persona con el verbo en pasado. Ok. Y con el segundo verbo que escojan, me van a hacer otra oración, ¿ok? Pero en tercera persona, ya sea usando he o she o un nombre de sus compañeros, ¿ok? Recuerden que la estructura del auxiliar y el verbo principal no cambian, ¿ok? No cambian. No se les agrega S, S o I, E, S. Why not? Because it's a structure in simple past and they don't suffer those changes, okay? That's the only way. There you go. So let's start choosing one example from there. I mean, one example verb. Quiero que escojan un verbo de acá, ¿ok? Para hacer una oración en primera persona. Luego escojamos un segundo verbo para hacer una oración en tercera persona. How come? Using simple past. Let's remember. Usando el pasado simple. ¿Ok? Let's do it. Let's do it and let's see what's up. Just let me know when you finish, okay? So that way you can...
Dijo... Dijo una en tercera persona.
Y una en primera.
Una en primera, muy bien.
Yes, van a escoger dos verbos para ello, ¿ok? Un verbo para hacer una oración en primera y uno para hacer una en tercera.
Ok, thank you.
I got a teacher.
Okay, very good. Why don't you read it? If you have finished, let's read it. Si ya terminó, léamelas. Okay, mientras sus compañeros hacen las oraciones.
Okay, third person. I sent some email to my customers, and third person, she went to the party with Gilmer.
She went to the party with Gilmer.
What?
Yeah, this is the party man.
Wow, okay.
Finish teacher.
All right. Teacher. Yes. Okay. All right, Maritza and then Gilmer. Ah, Maritza.
Okay. I went to the pool last weekend.
Uh-huh. To the school last weekend?
Mm-hmm. I went to the pool.
Ah, to the pool. To the pool. Mm-hmm. Okay. There you go.
She did the homework in the afternoon.
Ah, okay. Very good. She did the homework in the afternoon. There you go. Thank you. Gilmer?
The third person, Jorge sent his homework to teacher.
Okay, I'm yeah. Waiting for that homework actually.
First person, I slept all night.
I slept
tonight.
All night. Yeah, all the night. Es mejor decir all night o last night, okay? All night is like toda la noche. Last night significa anoche. Pero no podemos decir tonight porque tonight es futuro.
Ahora, va a ser decir.
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
All right, very good. Thank you. Thank you.
Me.
Okay, Jorge.
hoy vengo a participar un poquito, que sé.
Yeah, man, I know.
Que me equivoque.
Devengando lo de ayer.
Ah, yeah, man, he has to participate. He has to no. Participate the most because yesterday you didn't practice that much. Yeah,
no, si true. Se dan cuenta, en habido día que no he dicho nada. Todo, ni me he reído.
Está bueno que devengue ahora.
Ay.
Exactly.
Ok.
Ahora number, es el viernes de Jorge.
Para la primera.
Ok, Jorge.
I go home.
Ah, Jorge, that's simple present. Eso es presente simple. Tenemos que hacerla en pasado.
Ya ven, en la comida equivoca. Va, ya regreso entonces, nos vemos.
¿Cuál es el pasado? okay. What is the simple past of go, Jorge? What is the simple past of go? You got to look on that. Simplemente cambiemos el verbo a pasado, okay? Who else has finished? ¿Quién más terminó?
turn on your microphone and read it. Okay, let's see.
Finish.
Okay, cool. William, let's read. Then Eric and then Fatima.
Okay, she went center travel and I bought a guitar.
Okay, I bought a guitar. Good. But you're not like me, right? That I bought a guitar like 2 years ago because I wanted to play the guitar. I wanted to learn how to play the guitar. And you know what? I didn't learn. I have the guitar there. Dirty, by the way. Nah, so sad. Se suponía que había comprado una guitarra para aprender. Nunca aprendí. Y ahí está toda polvosa. That was funny. Okay, William. Thank you. Eric.
Okay, I sent the email in the morning.
Okay, very good.
They bought some hamburgers.
Repeat again.
They bought some hamburgers.
Algunas hamburguesas.
Mm-hmm.
Eliminémosle a. Solo dejémosle a. Some hamburgers.
Some hamburgers.
Yes.
Okay.
Very good. Thank you, Eric. Fatima.
You're welcome.
I spoke with my friends the last weekend. And she bought a new dress. ¿Qué pasa, teacher?
I mean, that's correct.
Thank you. Es por la oración. Es por la oración. No, el significado
de la oración. That's correct. That's correct. Solo esperaba ver esa reacción suya. Así como, what happened? ¿Qué hice mal?
Thank no, you, gracias.
Correct. Okay, no problem. Let's see, who else has finished? Romeo, do you finish? Not yet? Okay. Vanessa, are you there?
Yes, teacher, sorry. I am driving to my home.
Really? Are you driving yet?
Ah, yo acabo de venir, teacher. Acabo de venir. Ahorita voy a hacerlas.
Okay, okay. There you go. Rosa, how about you?
I bought a new TV and Elsie worked at the weekend.
Let's repeat the last one, please.
Elsie worked at the weekend.
Okay, all right. All right, thank you, Rosa. Now, let's see. Carla, did you solve the issue with the audio? Okay, I think she didn't. Ana Garcia, do you do the examples? Ana, are you there?
No, teacher.
No sé si están buenas.
Okay, okay. First Ana and then you, Jonathan, okay?
Okay.
Okay, Anna, let's go for it.
I send email every day.
En este caso, como la acción es en pasado, lo que podemos hacer ahí es esto. Look, you might say, I send emails. Okay, emails. You might say, yesterday. Okay, last week, last month. Okay, last year. Okay, that way, but not every day, porque every day es esa expresión de tiempo, si recuerdan del módulo pasado. Every day significa como todos los días. And the word every day, we use it, let's remember, we use it with simple present.
lo usamos con presente simple, ¿ok? So that's why it cannot fit in here. There you go.
Podemos usar this morning.
Yeah, this morning puede ser usada, ¿ok? Aunque igual, this morning es más que todo para presente perfecto. Cuando una acción en realidad no ha terminado. También la que podemos usar y puede ser más común es, por ejemplo, when we say, look, I sent emails, and you might say 5 minutes ago, 5 hours ago. You see, we can do this. What else? 5 days ago. 5 months ago. 5 weeks ago. All right, or even 5 years ago. You see? En este caso, la palabra ago significa hace, okay? Hace 5 minutos, hace 5 horas, hace 5 días, hace 5 semanas, hace 5 meses, hace 5 años. You see? That's to express something in the past, okay? Es para expresar algo en pasado. There you go. But, I mean, Ana, let's read the second example.
Jeffrey is asleep at night last week.
Casi no lo escucho, Fatima. Why am I mentioning Fatima? Ana, I don't listen to you, I mean, that much. ¿Podría repetirlo otra vez, por favor? Casi no lo escucho muy bien.
Permítame un segundo.
Ok. I mean, now it's better. Nubi is here.
I see.
Finally. Yes.
Jeffrey is asleep at night last week.
En vez de poner is y poner sleep, coloquemos el verbo, recordemos, el verbo en pasado, que sería slept. Ok. Si usamos practice, sería...
Left se dice, es que así lo he puesto, pero no.
vaya, sí, entonces la pronunciación es slept.
Slept.
Sí, solo que is, sí, ya no iría.
Solo Jeffrey left.
Slept.
Ok.
Yeah, Jeffrey slept last week or last weekend or last night, whatever you want to say, okay, or yesterday. Ahí dependiendo del tiempo en el que esté hablando, okay.
Okay.
All right. Thank you, Ana. Jonathan, let's do it.
Okay. I bought a phone for the cell phone. He has left it in the work.
Let's read the second one. I didn't listen that much.
He has left it asleep. No sé cómo se pronuncia con la R.
¿El verbo sleep?
Sí.
Aquí lo acabo de notar en la pantalla, Jonathan. Es slept.
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 Slept in the work.
Ok. Se durmió en el trabajo. Como se duermen en la clase, right? That is funny. Ok. There you go, Jonathan. Thank you. Who else is missing? Let's see. Nubia, por venir tarde. Let's read.
Hi, teacher.
Hi, Nubia.
¿Qué es lo que están haciendo?
Sentences, Nubia. Examples. Using simple past.
Hi.
Ajá. Con esos verbos que tenemos ahí, los podemos conjugar en pasado, Nubia. ¿Ok? For example, we got the verb
esos work. Verbos hacer oraciones en pasado.
Exactly. Solo escoja dos. Una para hacer en primera persona y otra en tercera.
Sí, okay. I spoke Portuguese. Last year.
Okay, last year. Very good. An extra example. Using third person.
Y la otra sería she bought the blouse last weekend.
Nah, okay. She bought that blouse, the last weekend. Thank you, Nubia. Very good.
Okay.
Roxana.
I went to the park in the night.
Ah, okay. Very good. I went to the park last night.
He spoke in public.
Ah, okay. Very good. He spoke in public. Thank you, Roxana.
Thank you, Chef.
All right, Jennifer, are you there?
Oops, perdón, no podía encender el micrófono. I work in a clinic and they practice after class.
Ah, okay. They practice after class. Thank you, Jennifer. Let me see who else is connected. Hey, Stephanie, let's read your examples. Stephanie? This is Rutia, are you there?
Mama, cayó otro abajo.
Hi, teacher.
Hi. What does the kid say?
Fíjese que como me acabo de conectar y el niño tenía mucha bulla, no le escuché, pero dígame.
¿Se acaba de conectar?
¿Hola?
¿Qué decía? No lo escuché muy bien.
No le escucho.
¿Y ahora?
¿Hola?
Hi.
Hoy sí.
Ok. ¿Me mencionaba del niño algo así?
Sí, que me acabé de conectar y como él está jugando cerca de mí, me estaba de preguntar cosas, no le escuché lo que me preguntó, lo que me dijo.
Ah, ok. Yeah, I mean, we are doing examples with those verbs. Estamos haciendo una práctica básicamente, un feedback de las principales temas que estuvimos discutiendo a las clases anteriores. Uno de ellos es el uso del pasado simple de los verbos y estábamos haciendo algunos ejemplos y quería que me diera un ejemplo usted.
Ah.
Yes, with those verbs, con los verbos que tiene en pantalla.
Cualquier ejemplo.
Yes.
Ok. I went.
Ajá.
I went to the mall last week.
No, okay. I went to the mall last week. That's pretty cool. All right, that's gonna be enough. Thank you, Stephanie. Carla, do you solve the issue with the audio? And I think the issue continues. Okay, I think she doesn't listen. That is weird. Okay, but let's continue. Let's continue, people. I'm going to erase this part because it's time to continue. Just give me a second. It's 9:05. Yes.
Teacher, yo copié la, el párrafo que había escrito. Ajá. Usted, pero ¿a qué se, no escuché a qué se refería con esos, este, con esas palabras? ¿O en qué momento se van a usar?
Las que acabo de eliminar.
Ajá, esas.
Esos solo son verbos, Roxana, que los podemos conjugar en pasado. Esos son los que nos han servido para hacer oraciones en pasado, ¿ok? Yeah, we got them in simple present, los escribí en presente simple y a la par escribí la forma pasada de esos verbos.
Y abajo en donde había puesto I sent email yesterday.
Ah, that was an example in simple past.
Ah, okay, okay. Gracias. Yeah.
Okay, no problem. All right, just give me a second. I'm going to pass the attendance list. And then we are going to continue. Thank you, Maritza, to remind me. I don't have the cell phone pretty close from here. So, thank you. Okay. All right. Let's see. Okay. Let's start the attendance list, Ana Claribel. Ana Claribel, are you there? Ay, ¿dónde está Ana? Se nos fue Ana. Okay. Ana María is not here. Carlos Ademir. Not here, right? Okay. Eric Guillermo.
Present, teacher.
Eric. Lo veo hasta deshidratado.
Créeme que sí, teacher.
You look, I mean, man, you look like you're dying, man.
Sí, realmente sí, como goma me ha dado. Así como dice
Gilbert. Diga la verdad, Eric, diga la verdad, Eric.
All right, let me, ¿sabe quién va a decir la verdad? Let me see. Sara, do you have Eric as a client today?
No, no. Dígale que no estuve las dos horas ahora ahí, Sara.
Le llegó Eric como cliente ahora.
¿Cómo fue, Eric? Perdón, ¿qué tengo de decir?
No, es que si no llego mañana.
Dice que fue el calor que usted estaba ahí, dice que por eso está un poquito mal.
Yeah.
Es cierto, o sea.
Lo puso a probar un Four Loco, por eso lo tiene así.
Ay, teacher, no, eso no. Eso no, teacher, eso no lo ven.
Pero bien. Bien sabe, teacher.
No, no.
You
know what I'm saying that? Porque un amigo, hace, la semana pasada fue, actually.
Sí, así dice uno siempre. Un amigo, una amiga.
No, you know what? You know what? No, I cannot drink any type of alcohol now. I mean, any type of beverage like that because I'm taking some pills. I'm taking medicine. So, and just imagine, estoy tomando una medicina que literal. The doctor told me. El doctor me dijo, si tomo una gota de alcohol,
lo va a mandar a la luna.
No, listen, la medicina se lo triplica. I don't know how, like, but
you fly
like the triple, and it was like, no, prefiero
no. Lo único, teacher, que no se puede ser, que se recomienda, o sea, si usted está tomando desparasitantes, no puede tomar.
Ah, no, no, I mean, puede. I did it like 3 months ago from that.
¿Cómo se llama?
Es lo único.
Yeah, that medicine.
Van a salir bien bolos los gusanos.
Exactly.
Es que se les va a matar por eso.
That was funny. Okay, let's continue. Ever de Jesús.
Aclárenles que no es por eso. Aclaro que no es por eso.
Ajá, ajá, ya.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see. Ever.
Present.
Okay, good. Fátima Alejandra.
Present.
Now, okay. Then we got Jonathan Alexander.
Present.
Okay, very good. Jorge Elvir.
Present.
Nice. Carla Benazir. I mean, Carla got issues, right? And I think she didn't solve them. Maritza Alcira.
I'm here, teacher.
Perfect. Natalie Vanessa. Natalie.
Present.
Ah, okay. Good. Rosa del Carmen.
Present.
Ah, okay. Ruth Joanna.
Present, teacher.
Ah, okay. Good. Sara Carolina.
Present, teacher.
Okay, nice. Stephanie Lisette.
Present.
Okay. Vanessa Odette.
Present, teacher.
Okay. William Alberto.
Present.
Very nice. Let's keep going. Roxana Yesenia.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Nubia Zulema.
Present, teacher.
Okay, nice. Jennifer Noemi. Okay, and Diana Gabriela.
All right, sure. I mean, I mentioned.
Didn't I? Yeah, I did it. Let me see. Hilmar. I've got it here, Hilmar. Yeah, Hilmar, you got the second attendance. Yes, okay. There you go.
Chef.
Yes.
No problema con el Inter. Creo que ya me había mencionado cuando me volvió a conectar.
Sí, ya la había mencionado. Okay. All right. Yeah, I got it. I got you there. Okay, no problem. Let's continue where we stayed. Yeah, it was here. Okay, so what have we got here? Simple past of being negative statement. Let's go like a little bit faster with this because I need to you to move on because right after this, we are going to do a series of exercises. The structure, let's remember, esta es la estructura que tenemos para formar oraciones en el pasado simple usando was or were. Let's remember, subject plus be plus not plus complement, okay? Recordemos, dependiendo del subject que tengamos, así va a ser la forma del verbo to be que coloquemos, okay? Examples, I was not excited. Okay, check that out. I was not excited. En este caso, a pesar de que excited lleva ed al final, podríamos tomarlo como si fuese un verbo. Pero en realidad, excited no es un verbo. What is the word excited? Ah, easy. The word excited is an adjective. Okay, la palabra, okay, es un adjetivo. By the way, what does excited mean in Spanish? ¿Qué es excited?
Emocionado.
Exactly, right? Emocionado. There you go. So, let's continue. Sara, todavía no me participa, así que, let's read.
You were not in the setup. No sé, teacher.
All right, you were not in the ceremony.
Ceremony, okay.
Okay, very good, thank you. You were not in the ceremony, okay. Jorge.
He was not a teacher.
Okay, very good. He was not a teacher. Jonathan.
What
point?
You were not in the ceremony.
Jonathan, no le escuché.
You were not in the ceremony.
No, Jonathan, the last one. La última.
She was not a member of the company.
Okay, thank you. All right, she was not a member of the company. And then we got another one, Roxana.
Teacher,
They were not in San Miguel.
Nah, ok, there you go. Recordemos que estas oraciones las podemos colocar contractadas también. ¿Cómo así? Contractar was y not. I wasn't excited. You weren't in the ceremony. He wasn't a teacher. She wasn't a member of the company. And the last one, they weren't in San Miguel, all right? We can contract was or were and they were not, okay? Into one single structure. Now, that was using the verb be. Ahora bien, eso era parte usando el verbo to be. Let's remember, we are just doing a feedback, okay? Now, let's use the simple past negative statements, but in this case, using the structure. Primero voy a mostrar la estructura para que tengamos una idea y podamos recordar. ¿Cuál es la estructura del pasado en este caso? Let me check. Simple past negative statements. Okay, let's remember, tenemos subject plus did plus not plus
un complement.
Ah.
Plus, not.
Main
verb.
Main. Simple present. Plus complement. Plus the question mark. All right. Good. Let's write down one example. Check this out. Check this out. In an affirmative statement, I can say, Fatima did the homework. Ah, Fatima hizo la tarea. Esa es una oración afirmativa, ¿cierto? Check this out. Affirmative. Fatima did the homework. En este caso, el verbo did no está actuando como auxiliar, está actuando como verbo principal, ¿ok? Don't get confused. Ahora bien, ¿cómo transformar esta oración positiva en negativa? Fátima, let's remember, Fátima is the subject, ajá. Fátima did not, vamos a hacer la primera así de la forma larga para que podamos recordar un poco así. Fátima did not, y ahora que dice la forma del verbo, ¿cómo tiene que ir? In simple present o base form, ok, tiene que ir en forma base o presente simple, como le solemos llamar. En este caso es did, ¿cómo será la forma presente?
Do.
Exactly. The homework. Ya la palabra the homework es básicamente el complemento, ¿okay? That is an informal way to do it. Recordemos, esa es una forma bien formal de hacerlo, ¿okay? Ahora, informal. Fátima didn't. Si ven aquí, ya contractamos did y not. Fátima didn't do the homework. Yeah, I mean, Fátima didn't do the homework. She never do the homework. There you go. So you see, we got two ways. Entonces tenemos ahí dos formas. La forma más práctica que vamos a practicar y que hemos estado practicando es didn't. Let's remember that, okay? Let's remember that. Another negative example. Nubia didn't get married. Sara didn't connect yesterday. Let's put to the class yesterday. Let's write down something else. Let's see. Give me a name. I'm gonna set up. Jennifer didn't turn on the camera during the class. You see, that's another example.
It's I'm direct.
Ah?
Una indirecta. Esa es una indirecta, teacher.
Ah, no, I don't know what is that. No soy el tipo de personas que lanzan indirectas. No soy como otros por ahí, ¿verdad? Yes. And look at Eric, he's like, oh. You're dying, Eric. All right, so let's take a look at this. Entonces, ¿cuál es la única diferencia en este tipo de oraciones, las unas con las otras? Primero, el subject, ¿ok? Segundo, el verbo principal que indica la acción. Recordemos que para cada oración va a ser una acción diferente. Por consiguiente, cada complemento, ¿ok? Será diferente. So you see? Cada complemento va a ser diferente dependiendo del verbo del que estemos colocando acá. ¿Ok? ¿Qué va a permanecer? Didn't. Ahí didn't no cambia en tercera persona, no cambia en ninguna otra forma. ¿Right? Y luego el verbo principal, el que vamos a indicar acción. Igual, no cambia ya sea en primera o tercera persona. Let's remember, it doesn't change. Okay? Let's see a series of examples that we had in a presentation before. All right, let's see who can help me out reading. Romeo, let's read.
He didn't meet his weird 6 year
his wife.
Wife.
Uh-huh. His wife.
Here. ¿Cómo se dice la abreviación?
Ago. Okay. Thank you, Romeo. He didn't meet his wife 6 years ago. Like, él no conoció a su esposa hace 6 años. Okay. There you go. Fátima.
I didn't graduate from the university.
University. Okay. Thank you. I didn't graduate from the university. Like, no me gradué de la universidad. So you see? That's the way how we can translate that part. Okay. Jorge.
They didn't watch a movie yesterday.
Ah, okay, very good. They didn't watch a movie yesterday. Nubia.
You didn't go to bed early.
Yes, I didn't go to bed early yesterday. Yeah, I mean, it was hard for me. I went to bed at 1:30 in the morning. That's why I'm like Eric. Like, it's dying. Look at Eric, man. He's like, look into the moon. Okay, let's continue. Vanessa, let's read.
She didn't study in the library.
In the library. What is library, Vanessa?
Librería.
No.
Biblioteca.
Yes, biblioteca.
Ah.
¿Cómo se dice librería?
Library.
Ah.
Library es biblioteca, ¿verdad?
Yes. ¿Y librería, cómo decimos librería en inglés?
Bookstore.
Yes, bookstore. There you go. Bookstore. Very good. Let's continue. Thank you, Vanessa. Ya, yeah, se lo voy a escribir, Vanessa. Porque Nick hizo una carita ahí como que, what? Dale, give me a second. I'm going to write it down in the chat. Bookstore. This way. What? What happened? I got it. Bookstore. That's the way. Eric, let's read the example.
We didn't buy a cake for you.
Nah, so sad. You didn't buy a cake for me? Not possible, man. Okay.
No, no hacen envíos to
delivery. Javier.
No hacen deliveries por esta zona, dicen. Se van a perder por los cerros. Oh my God. That's the good part of living in the top of a tree. There you go. Ever, let's read.
The police didn't find any clues.
Ah, okay, the police didn't find any clues. Okay, good. Let's see. Now, I want people, listen, I want you to bring up any action that you did today in simple past. Okay, ahora, quiero que de este día, tomen una acción de algo que no hicieron y me lo digan. Example. In my case, I didn't have the lunch today. I didn't have the lunch today. Okay? It's like, no almorcé. There you go. What did you do, people? In this case, what didn't you do que no hicieron?
Me, I didn't go to the work.
Ah, okay. Very good, Marisa. You didn't go to work. Nubia?
I didn't send emails.
Okay, you didn't send emails. There you go. Who else? ¿Quién más?
I didn't go to the gym.
Ah, okay, very good. You didn't go to the gym. Are you going to the gym, Sara?
A mediodía.
A mediodía. Okay. Good. Una vez dije, ah, no, acá, en Oriente, you know, like, yeah, we're hot. It's like, iré al gimnasio a las 11 hasta la 1, porque pues, no hay gente, it's like, está vacío, aparte pues, el calor, me ayudará a quemar energía, grasa, mi grasa. You know what? Acabé deshidratado. That was mine. Se me bajó la presión, no sé, pero el caso es que sentí que me iba a desmayar. It was like a drunk person in there in the gym. Yeah, I mean, that's horrible. That's really horrible. Esos son los inicios del gym. All right, Hilmar, go.
I did not check my personal email.
Nah, okay, very good. Who else? Want to talk about one activity that you didn't do, people?
Your teacher.
Okay, Fatima.
I didn't take a coffee in the morning.
Qué pecado. That's a sin, Fatima.
No tenía tiempo.
There is always time for a cup of coffee. Excuses, Fatima. Okay, thank you, Fatima. Ever, I see you want to participate.
Okay, I didn't do my running routine.
Nah, okay, all right. How many kilometers do you run?
Every day.
Uh-huh.
Every day at 5 a.m.
No, how many kilometers do you run every day?
It's 8 or 10 kilometers. Tires. What?
10 kilometers? Jesus Christ, that's a lot.
Yes.
Yeah. If I started running the way I am right now without doing exercise, without doing anything, I think the farthest I can go is like 1 block running. After 1 block, I will be like, oh, tired, dying.
Así se empieza, 100 metros.
Yeah, I mean, that's the way.
Poco a poco, ya con el tiempo se acostumbra.
Exactly, that's the way. Okay, there you go. William, let's tell me an activity that you didn't do today.
I didn't drive a train.
I didn't
drive
a
train.
Ah, okay. I didn't drive a train. Okay, William. There you go. Very good. Vanessa?
I didn't take my hour lunch.
Nah, okay. Very good. There you go. Jonathan?
Me.
Ah, okay. All right. Mimi, you go.
Mimi, you. I didn't pay the billing.
All right. Yeah, the bills.
Bills.
I mean, what's today's date? Jesus Christ, I haven't paid a lot of bills.
Yeah.
Thank you to remind me. I had to pay them tomorrow. Oh my God. Y yo así como que, I got money. But now I remember that I haven't paid the bills.
Hoy o mañana.
Yeah, I mean tomorrow. Has to be tomorrow. All right. Thank you, Jorge. Jonathan, let's read your example.
I didn't go to the bank.
Nah, okay.
Last day.
Last day. Okay, all right, the last day, el último día, that you had to go to the bank. Okay, I'll buy that one. Okay, good. Roxana? Let's give me your example, Roxana.
I didn't buy in the market.
Okay, you didn't buy in the market. There you go. Good. Romeo?
Okay. I didn't sleep.
Okay, you didn't sleep. Same here, I didn't sleep today. Yeah, okay, thank you, Romeo. Let's see. Mrs. Urrutia? Mrs. Urrutia, are you there?
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Let's see your example.
Caleb didn't go. Caleb didn't go to the school early. Yeah.
Okay, all right. Very cool. Thank you, Stephanie. Natalie?
I didn't do exercise at night.
Natalie, do you do exercise?
Sí, sí hago ejercicio, pero no me gusta hacerlo en las noches.
Nah, okay.
Sí, prefiero las mañanas.
Okay. No, I'm asking that because you look very slim. You're not like, you're not like, yeah, you look slim. It's like, and I was like, ¿por qué?
Eso no es.
Yeah, I mean, it's like, ¿por qué ese ejercicio? You got a cup party and everything. No, I mean, it's, for me, it's difficult to do exercise. One day in the future.
No le gusta, algún día, algún día.
I do like doing the exercise. The thing is that I don't have time to do exercise. You know what? Since I woke up at 4 in the morning and I had to go to you know, like to work, and I had to start working at 6:30. Then I got home in here 7:45. So I got just 15 minutes break, and then I start this class. When I finish this class at 10 or something, I had to convert the video, upload the video on YouTube. So when I'm finishing with that, it's probably 12. So I don't have enough time. Yeah, so sad. Hilmar, you participated already, right? ¿Ya participó, Hilmar? I don't remember. All right, I think Hilmar is not there. Sara, did you do it already? Sara, are you there? All right, where are these people? Okay, let's see the last person. Anna, are you there?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, Anna, can you read your example?
I didn't listen to music.
Nah, okay, very good, Anna. I didn't listen to music. There you go. Now, let's just see the other part, the other counterparts that we got. Let's remember, those were just structures to mention negative statements. Now, this is a structure for a just no question. Ahora bien, esta era prácticamente la clase que estuvimos viendo el, let me see, lunes, on Monday. If you remember, this class was about just no questions, okay? Using the simple past. Simplemente vamos a ver esta información, pero recuerden, esta información ya la vimos, okay? This is just feedback, okay? So just pay attention, because right after these examples, let's finish the last example, and then we are going to go back to the manual. Okay, this is the structure, okay? Esta es la estructura, si la recuerdan. We use did plus subject plus base form of the verb plus complement and the question form. Examples. Did you have class yesterday? You see, did es el auxiliar, you es el subject, have es la forma base del verbo, okay? Class yesterday es complemento, okay? And then we got the question mark. Okay, recordemos. I mean, like weird. Dime, se me traban las soluciones. Yes, I did. Just take it that way, right? Yes, I did. Don't take this one. This one next. Okay? And neither this one. I was sleeping when I did this. Okay, it's like, just yes, I did, or no, I didn't. Vamos a tomarlo con la forma corta, okay? Just yes, I did, and no, I didn't. Let's remember we can answer that way just to make it simpler, para hacerlo un tanto más simple, okay? Un tanto más simple y no tan complicado, y no poder así de cierta manera redundar en lo que nos están preguntando, ¿ok? Or repeat what you have been answering. Okay. Now, we got some extra examples. And let's see, Maritza, help me read this question.
Did you call a mechanic to check your car? Mechanic.
Uh-huh.
Did you call a mechanic to check your car?
Okay, thank you. And it says, yes, I did. I called a mechanic to check my car. Okay, o simplemente lo podemos hacer de la forma más corta. Yes, I did, and that's it, okay? Roxana, let's read the second question.
Did she pay extra money?
Okay, good. It says, no, she didn't, right? Ahí simplemente pondremos la forma más corta. No, she didn't, and that's it. William, help me reading this question. William, are you there? Hello. Okay, I think he's not there. Let's see. Ruth, help me reading, please.
Did we receive a report?
All right, did we receive a report? Yes, we did, right?
Yes,
as a possible answer, or no, we didn't. The negative answer, okay, to that type of question. Just we did or not, we didn't. Okay, good. If you're copying that, just try to move on, okay. And let's check. As I told you, we are not going to stop that much in here. And let's see the last one, okay? The last one. Simple past information questions. This talks only about the simple past information questions, the ones that we were practicing yesterday, okay? And we got the structure. Solo para recordar la estructura que estuvimos hablando ayer. Let's see. WH word plus did. Plus subject, plus base form of the verb, in this case, and plus complement, okay? We got a complement. And at the end, the question mark. Examples. Fatima, read the example.
Where did you go yesterday?
Okay, very good. Thank you. Ever?
I went to the office yesterday.
Okay, very good. Nubia, tell me a reading.
What time did you finish the homework?
Okay, very good. What time did you finish the homework? Sara?
I finished the homework at 7 p.m.
Okay, very good. I finished the homework at 7 p.m. There you go. Thank you. Okay, so let's remember, ¿qué es lo único que varía de este tipo de preguntas con el anterior, con las yes no questions? Lo único que cambia es que en estas les agregamos las WS word, okay? If you remember the WS words, they are what, where, what time, what kind of, which, who, why, okay? And sometimes we use how, okay? Just to create questions, okay? Dependiendo del tipo de WS word que pongamos en la pregunta, así va a ser el tipo de respuesta. Let's remember, si hablamos de what time, en ese caso, estamos hablando o estamos pidiendo a qué hora se hizo una actividad. Si decimos where, dónde se hizo esa actividad. Si decimos which place, estamos pidiendo el lugar específico donde se hizo esa actividad. Si decimos who, Ah, estamos diciendo con quién hicimos esa actividad. Ok, let's remember that. And if we use when, ah, si usamos when, recordemos en qué momento se hizo esa actividad en el pasado. And if we use why, ah, entonces estamos pidiendo una razón del por qué se hizo esa actividad. Ok. Every WH word correspond to any specific question. Ok. All right, Eric, let's read.
What did he buy?
Okay, what did he buy? You see, Rosa, let's read. Rosa.
He bought a television.
Ah, okay, very good. He bought a television. Okay, thank you. Natalie, let's read.
Who did she pay for the product to?
Okay, let's see who can help me out with this. Jonathan.
She paid for the product to the seller.
Ah, okay, thank you. Romeo.
Where did they sell the house?
Where did they sell the house? Okay, thank you. Sarah. Sara, you got the microphone off.
Okay, me café a teacher.
Okay.
The house in San Miguel.
Thank you. Okay, there you go, people. As I told you, we are not going to stop in here because I need we to finish one of the main exercises that we got in one of the page in the manual. So let's open the manual.
Teacher.
Yes.
¿Puede regresar la lámina anterior, por
favor? Exactamente, lo mismo es.
Ah, connected each one of them. Okay, good. There you go.
Thank you, teacher.
Okay, good. All right. So I'm gonna finish that. Let's work in the manuals. I'm gonna stop sharing a moment and I'm gonna project the specific part that I want you to work, okay? There you go. Let's go to the page 38 from the manual. Page 38. Okay, vámonos a la página 38 del manual, okay. And what are we going to do here? Listen, simple past. Es básicamente lo que hemos estado viendo. Simple past, dice. Transform the negative sentences into positive ones. ¿Qué vamos a hacer acá? Ah, las oraciones acá las tenemos en negativo. They are in negative. What do we have to do? Las vamos a transformar en oraciones positivas acá. ¿Ok? That's the way how we are going to be working. ¿Cómo así? Ah, easy. Take this out, people. Si acá dice, she didn't buy that computer, ¿cómo va a ser como oración positiva? Help me out.
She bought that computer.
There you go. Recuerden, acá no vamos a usar did. Ok, y vamos a usar el verbo en pasado porque es la forma pasada simple. Ok, afirmativa. Ok, let's remember. So we got number one in there. So ya tenemos la primera entonces. There you go. Vamos a hacer algo. Listen, easier. Very easy. Ever. Let me see.
Yeah,
ocho. Okay, Ever, you will do example number two Fátima, example number three, no olviden su número. Example number three, Fátima. Maritza, number four. Roxana, number five, okay. Nubia, number six. Eric, number seven. And the last one, Jorge, number eight, okay. Number eight. People, si por algún motivo la oración nos sale errónea, ustedes tienen la libertad de escoger a uno de sus compañeros que no mencioné para que les pueda ayudar, ¿ok? There you go. So I will give you time for you to copy the exact word, ¿ok? And the rest, try to follow up. Try to continue. Recuerden, simplemente van a pasar esas oraciones a afirmativas. Let's go fight. A los que mencioné, when you're ready, just let me know, okay? Let me know. Teacher, I'm finished.
Finished, teacher.
Okay, perfect, Maritza. Let's finish, people. Fatima, you finish? Okay, good. Ever? All right, Eric? A medias, como Ana ahorita. All right, Jorge, good. Okay, let's read number two. Who got number two? ¿Quién tiene el número dos?
Okay. Bring that packages.
Let's see. We
bring that package.
Let's remember, Ever, the example has to go in simple past. Recordemos que el ejemplo, la oración está en pasado. Lo único que va a hacer es transformar la positiva, pero en pasado. Ahí tenemos didn't. Ajá, exactly.
Ah, ok, brought.
Yes. We brought. Exactly. All right. We brought that package.
That package.
There you go. It's a simple pass. Very good. Now, who got number three?
Yo, teacher.
Okay, read.
The client called yesterday.
Ah, okay, very good. The client called yesterday. Very nice. Who got number four?
I.
There you go.
The employees read the email.
This way?
Yes.
Okay, vuelva a leer, por favor.
The employees read the email.
Okay, one correction, Maritza. Este verbo es un verbo irregular, okay? Pero este verbo, a pesar de que se escribe lo mismo, se pronuncia como el color rojo en pasado. It's red, okay?
Yes,
red. Very good.
Red. The employees read the email.
Very good. Very good. Thank you, Maritza. Now, who got number five? Number five.
Our boss came back last week.
Came back last week. Okay, very good. There you go. That's the way how we do it. Thank you, Roxana.
Okay, teacher.
Number next. What is number number six? Okay.
They
canceled like this. Or this?
This
canceled.
The meeting.
This one? This way or that way, all right? ¿Con una L o doble L, Nubia?
Double L.
Are you sure? Are you sure, Nubia?
No, yo digo que con una.
Nah, Nubia, it's the double L.
¿Por qué?
All right, ¿por qué? Porque cae, listen, in English, para ciertos verbos, para ciertos adjetivos, también hay una regla en inglés que se llama CVC rule. La regla del CVC. What is CVC in English? All right, listen. CVC, consonant, vowel, consonant. Cuando un verbo o un adjetivo termina en esta regla, consonant, vowel, consonant, generalmente lo que hacemos es duplicar la última letra, ¿ok? Por eso, es que en el adjetivo big, de grande, decimos en comparativo bigger, agregamos otra G, ¿ok? That's one of the ways. Okay. Eso probablemente se vea más adelante. Yeah, because you're going to practice adjectives.
Okay. Sí, porque yo me quedé, ¿qué?
yeah. You will study that in, I think in module number 5. 5 or 6, I don't remember exactly. Okay, who got number 7?
The lady wanted to complain.
The lady wanted
to complain.
Okay, very good. Thank you. And the last one.
Me.
Okay.
I sent the refund to this email.
I sent the refund
to this email.
Okay, very good. So this is the way how we got the examples in here, right? So just compare the examples that you have, people, for the rest. And if you have in this way, so then you are correct. Okay, you are correct. Let's see, what's the next exercise that we got? This is gonna be the last one because it's pretty short and we're gonna do it this way. Let's see. Save them. How are we going to do? We are going to do it this way. Give me a second. Oh my God. Clear all the drawings. There you go. Okay. There are 6. Okay, listen. Listen, how are we going to do this? Escuchen cómo vamos a hacer esto. Since we haven't been practicing in the discussion section in the platform, okay, that part is missing in the platform. Listen, what are we going to do? Estos ejercicios, estos verbos que tienen acá en específico, en paréntesis en específico, tenemos el verbo do, tenemos el verbo go, buy, work, read and see. Okay. how are we going to do this? Dice la indicación. Listen. Create information questions using the verbs given. Then ask the questions and write the answer. ¿Qué es lo que quiero que hagan? Listen. No lo vamos a hacer ahorita, porque básicamente nos tardaríamos bastante, ¿ok? We will do it, like, it will take longer. ¿Pero qué vamos a hacer? I want you to do it, ¿ok? I want you to do it, pero lo vamos a hacer, listen, lo vamos a hacer en la discussion section de la plataforma. ¿Cómo así? Voy a colocar la indicación ahí en la discussion section de la plataforma, ¿ok? Y usted solo va a abrir la discussion section y me va a crear la pregunta con esos verbos, ¿ok? Example. Listen. Tenemos el verbo do, ¿ok? Tenemos el verbo do. Voy a colocar ese verbo así en la plataforma. ¿Qué es lo único que usted va a hacer? Vamos a hacer el número uno, ¿ok? Para que simplemente hagamos 5 preguntas nada más. A modo de ejemplo, el verbo do. Recordemos que con information questions podemos hacer uso de cualquiera de las WH words. Entonces voy a usar why. Why did... Aquí serán libres de escoger si quieren hacerlo en primera persona o tercera persona. ¿Ok? Lo vamos a hacer en primera persona. Why did you do... Why did you do?
What did you do?
The homework. You see? Why did you do the homework? Ah, ya tenemos la information question. You see? It's difficult. I don't think it's difficult, right? ¿Por qué no creo que sea tan difícil? Porque hemos estado practicando esta estructura. Lo estuvimos haciendo ayer. And besides that, y aparte de ello, ya conocemos el vocabulario, especialmente los verbos. Los verbs are very, you know, common, right? We have been practicing those verbs. So, what do I want from you people? Entonces, quiero que algo así, exactamente así, me hagan con las demás preguntas. Solo que pueden variar, les vamos a variar con las WH words, ¿ok? Me pueden usar what time, when, ok, why, where, okay, depending. Serían 5 oraciones. Yo voy a, como les dije, voy a poner la indicación, voy a dejar los verbos y ustedes hacen lo demás, ¿ok? You got tomorrow the whole day. Tienen mañana en el transcurso del día lo podemos hacer, ¿ok? Let's do it. Antes de comenzar a pasar asistencia, listen, hay algunos que todavía me deben tarea, ¿ok? Tarea atrasada, no tarea 15, porque hoy algunos solo me han llegado a tarea 14 y ahora terminarían tarea 15, porque ahora en la noche tengo que subir notas al sistema. Listen, para ahora, please, try to do it, try to do them. Los que vamos atrasados, traten de completármelas, por favor, porque luego, así nos evitamos de que es del, you know, like, people from the company calls you. Así se evitan de que las personas de la empresa los estén llamando, los estén incomodando, you know, like, o quitándoles tiempo valioso. Y así pues, we are okay with everything, okay? Recuerden, sería hasta la tarea 15, okay? Because I need to upload those grades, porque sí necesito subir esa nota, okay? So, entonces quedaríamos pendientes con eso para los que todavía no lo han terminado. And if you don't have any other question, we're going to stay being here, people. And tomorrow we will continue with week 4. Y mañana prácticamente iniciaríamos con semana 4. Okay? So, just give me a second. I'm going to pass the attendances. Now, Eric is smiling because he's going to bed. Good, man. Good.
Sí, no, es que Marix se me estaba escribiendo y preguntándome que por qué estaba así, ¿verdad? Y ya le expliqué, y que estaba explicando que una reacción de la vacuna, ¿verdad? Entonces, nada, nada que... me tiene... Por eso está todo apagado, me dice. Sí.
Ya. Es que anduvo usando alcohol 90 y smelling it. No, a mí ya. No, es cierto, sí, la vacuna, sí, la tercera dosis está poniendo mal casi a todo el mundo.
Sí, y esa AstraZeneca,
Más reacción.
Exacto.
No tengo dolor, no tengo fiebre, nada, solo.
But the three of them were the same one? ¿Las tres fueron la misma?
No, las primeras dos fueron Sinovac.
Yeah, right.
Pregúntale las dos primeras rondas, ¿cómo fueron? Estaban tibias. La tomó muy helada.
Muy helada, hacen daño.
Yeah, I mean, and he ended up with chicha. That's why he's like, yeah. Okay.
Buena la chicha.
Let's continue. Let's see. Ana Claribel.
Ese.
Okay, good. Ana Maria didn't show up today. Carlos Ademir didn't show up.
Eric Ana Guillermo. María, teacher, andaba con migraña, me dijo que le avisara que no se iba a poder conectar porque había caído con un gran dolor de cabeza.
¿Really?
Oh. Ajá, de que entonces lo único que quería era descansar porque no aguantaba.
Ya me imagino, pobre. All right, thank you, Natalie.
Bueno.
Ok. Sí, Ever.
Present,
a mí no teacher.
Me mencionó, teacher, me puso ahí present.
Ah, yes, I mentioned it después de que Natalie. Yeah, that's
sorry.
Right. All right. So, Ever is here. Let's see who else. Fatima Alejandra.
Present, teacher.
Okay, good. Hilmar Cruz.
Present.
Okay, nice. Jonathan Alexander.
Present.
Okay, good. Jorge Elvir.
Present.
All right. Carla Benazir. Ahí va, es Carla. Carla. Jesus, she got promise. Margot Hernandez. All right, she had issues with something. Maritza Alcira.
I'm here, teacher.
Okay. Natalie Vanessa.
Present.
Okay, good. Romeo Alexis. All right, Romeo.
Sure.
Did we have the 10 minutes feedback last week?
Yes, yeah.
Sí, ¿verdad? La semana pasada.
Sí, la semana pasada.
Ah, okay. I thought it was your turn in here because I got you here. But it's Ruth Joanna today. Okay. So Ruth, we're gonna stay the 10 minutes feedback, okay? Okay, there you go. So let's see Rosa del Carmen. Rosa.
Present.
Ah, okay, thank you. Ruth Joanna.
Present.
Okay, good. Sara Carolina.
Teacher.
Okay, Sara, thank you. Stephanie Lisette.
Present.
All right, Vanessa Odette. Vanessa.
Present.
Okay. All right, thank you, Vanessa. And then we got William. All right, I think William left. Roxana Yesenia.
Present, teacher.
All right, Nubia Zulema.
Present, teacher.
Okay, Jennifer Noemi.
Present.
Okay, and we got Diana Gabriela, who didn't show up. Okay, people, as I told you, the ones who didn't do the homework, please do the homework. I'm going to post that on the discussion section, okay? I hope you had a wonderful night. and see you tomorrow in the beginning of the fourth week, okay? Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
All right, bye everybody.
Good night. Good night, everybody.
Good night. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
Good night.
Hope you feel better, Eric.
See you in the heaven.
Yes.
Oh, no, en cualquiera de los dos lugares tengo chero.
Yeah, man, me too.
Sí, novia, gracias.
Ya va a estar mejor, descanse.
Y a ver la luz al final del túnel.
A ver la luz al final del
túnel. Paso cerrado.
Qué bueno.
Exactly. Bye, bye. Bueno. Bye. Ah, yeah, man. Tomorrow will be okay. Talking in Chinese.
Okay.
All right, bye-bye.
Buenas noches. Bye.
Good night. Ciao. There you go. Bye-bye. Okay, just give me a second. I'm going to put this person into the waiting room. Okay, Ruth. Vamos a tener 10 minutos, los cuales nos van a servir para aclarar cualquier duda que usted pueda tener sobre esta clase y las clases anteriores. So, do you have any questions, Ruth?
La tarea número 12 no la he hecho porque no he entendido. Y la 13, hay dos que no me salen malas, no sé por qué. Okay. De ahí las demás ya están resueltas.
All right, vamos a ver entonces. Give me a second. Voy a compartir acá. Where do I have? Ah, this one. Okay. Give me a second. Okay, so I got this one. This is the module that we are in. Okay. Not I'm pretty sure. Okay. Okay, section 3. Which homework are you saying?
La tarea número 12.
Ah, 12. Okay. It's kind of slow. 12. This one? Esta?
Uh-huh. Sí. Ese es el mío. No,
va. No, this is mine. Este es el mío.
Ajá. Ah, ya, pues todas me salen error. No sé por qué. No entendí. Ajá. No entiendo. Es la única que no he hecho. Y la 14. Esa es la 12. La 13. La siempre me da error. Y ya revisé los puntos, todo eso. Y no sé en qué será.
¿Y con la 12 tiene problemas?
Sí, porque no la he podido hacer. Y como dice usted que ya va a revisar.
Vaya, mire, mire. Dice acá, instructions. Write the following positive sentences into negative sentences. Vamos a escribir into positive sentences into negative past sentence. Entonces, lo que vamos a hacer acá es que, si tenemos acá donde dice, her dog was thirsty, su perro tenía sed. Ah, entonces, mire, esa es la forma en cómo lo vamos a colocar. Her dog wasn't. Aquí lo que vamos a hacer es colocar el auxiliar que tenga ahí.
Uh-huh.
Ok, en negativo. Y aparte de eso, lo vamos a contractar.
Uh-huh.
Ok, por ejemplo, dice acá, mire. I found $10 on the street. Ah, encontré $10 en la calle. ¿Cómo vamos a transformar esa en negativo? Ruth?
I wasn't not fun.
No, en este caso, no. aquí era wasn't, porque aquí tengo was. Pero como acá ya no tengo was, entonces ya no puede ser was. Tiene que ser el auxiliar did en negativo.
I didn't.
Ah, exactly. I didn't. Ahora el verbo found tiene que estar en presente. El verbo found, básicamente, la forma base de ese verbo, mire, es este, find, presente, found, pasado.
¿A dónde lo escribió?
Aquí. Aquí.
Ay, es que he acercado la pantalla, perdón. Ay, no veo
sin lentes. Find simple present, found simple past. Entonces, si recuerda, en esta parte, lo que necesitamos es después del didn't, es el verbo en forma base. Entonces sería aquí find. Recuerde, find es la forma presente de este verbo que tenemos acá. ¿Ok? Luego colocamos el símbolo de dólares. Luego, dollar on the street. ¿You see?
Sí,
ay, luego lo demás. Didn't.
I think.
Mire, I didn't find $10 on the street. Ahora bien, vamos a ver si está bien. Le vamos a dar enviar.
Mm,
y mire.
No.
Mire.
I did. Fin. Todo va igual, ¿verdad? Dollar, solo fin, phone cambió.
Y agregarle el didn't. Le agregamos didn't.
Okay.
Check this out.
I feel strange. Ya me sigue dando, espérenme, ¿por qué me sigue dando error?
Va, revise, aquí lo tengo yo, mire, aquí lo tengo. Revise si así lo tiene.
Pues sí. ID, sí. Fin.
Va, se la voy a anotar, se la voy a anotar acá, mire, en la pantalla. I didn't find. Ok, el símbolo de dólar. $10. Ok. On the street. Luego solo se coloca lo demás de la pregunta. ¿Y sí?
Vale, espérame, se lo voy a poner aquí. Yo creo que usted puede ver aquí. Vale, se lo voy a poner como yo le he puesto en el chat.
Ah, ok, ok.
Se fue. Ah, sí, ahí está. Vale, yes. Así es, así lo tengo yo en mi plataforma. Y me sigue dando
error. No, es que mire, mire, usted tiene in the street y es on the street. On.
On.
Mire en la pantalla cómo lo tengo yo. ¿Ya vio?
Ajá, ahorita.
Check that. Revíselo ahí.
Hoy sí.
¿Y
sí? Vaya. Sí.
Ah, muy bien.
Vaya,
entonces, la número 3. Haga la número 3, quiero ver.
Ay.
Solo le puedo decir que en la número 3, solo le puedo decir, porque ahí ya no se la voy a hacer, le hice esa modo de ejemplo. Le voy a decir que en la número 3, el pasado del verbo went es go.
Go. Pero como no tenemos el was, también sería I didn't go.
Yes.
Ah, ok, bueno, pero pues. Calmados, que no entiendo.
All right. Ay. No problem.
Ay, sí, no le entendía para nada.
Sí, ya me imagino.
De ahí todo va igual, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Solo eso cambió.
Yes.
We, plus, we.
Vea bien cómo está en la oración para que no vaya a tener algo, que no le vaya a tirar error. ¿Le tiró mala?
Sí, pero me la voy a copiar para que usted la vea.
Ok. Sí, tenemos que ser bien cuidadosos en ese aspecto, porque a veces algo, una cosita, a veces nos hace falta y nos sale mal. Vamos a revisarlo. I didn't go. Ah, yes. Mire, le falta el to. To le falta. I didn't go to.
I didn't go to. Ok.
Ya ve, a veces una pequeña
palabra. Hoy sí.
You see, a veces una pequeña mínima palabrita es la que nos hace que la oración salga todo errónea.
Ajá, pues, la cuatro sería, I wasn't.
Ah, good. Ahora sí aparece was. Entonces, ahí.
Ajá, pero el verbo.
Ese es el verbo.
Así está bien.
Was es el verbo. I... Hay que ponerlo en negativo.
Ah, vaya. Ahorita.
Was es el verbo ahí, ¿ok?
Ajá. Vale, el otro.
¿Was okay?
Sí, el otro. I fled to San Francisco last year.
Flew es el verbo.
Ahí sería I didn't, no.
Ajá, I didn't. Y ahí sí quiero que busque este verbo, qué significa y cómo es la forma del presente.
Lo busco, ¿qué significa?
Ajá. En ese caso, se lo voy a dar. Se lo voy a dar. No se preocupe.
Ajá.
Fly. El verbo es fly.
Ajá.
Haga el resto usted.
Entonces sería, I didn't fly to San Francisco. Ah, ok.
There you go. You got it.
Vaya, teacher. Solo le voy a copiar las que me han salido mal, de la 13, que yo no entiendo. Tal vez alguna letra que yo no he visto.
Ok, ¿cuál es?
No, ahorita se lo pongo aquí en el chat.
Aquí solo son yes, no questions, las que va a escribir.
Ajá, ajá.
Ahora bien, look. Por ejemplo.
La 3 me salió mala.
Va, por ejemplo, vamos a dar el ejemplo de la 3, ¿ok? Para que usted pueda hacer la otra, que si hay otra que le salió mal.
Sí, la 3 y la 4.
Ok, vamos a hacer esta y usted hace la otra, ¿ok? Sin mi ayuda.
Ya se la puse ahí en el chat, la 3, como la hice yo.
Ah, el verbo es el que tiene mal. Usted tiene el verbo en pasado y tiene que estar en presente.
Ay.
Usted tiene went, pero acuérdese que went es pasado, así que no puede ir el verbo en pasado en pregunta.
Entonces es... Did I?
No, la estructura todo está bien, solo hay que cambiar el verbo a presente.
¿Y when? ¿El presente de when? Was.
No.
No sé.
Por ejemplo, I went to the hospital, I went to work, I went to the stadium. Fui al estadio, fui al hospital, fui a trabajar. ¿Cómo se dice ir?
Go.
Ah, ese es el presente.
Ah.
Went es la forma pasada.
O sea que solo go está.
A ver.
¡Ay, sí!
You see?
Ay, le voy a copiar la otra, porque sí ya la hice, pero a lo mejor va a decir eso, que no, el verbo no lo he puesto bien.
Sí, supongo que tiene boat ahí.
Ahí está el otro.
Yes, es lo mismo. Tiene el verbo en pasado y tiene que ser el verbo en presente.
Ay, señor. ¿Y ahí cuál es?
Boat. Boat es el verbo en pasado. Ahora bien, por ejemplo, I bought a car yesterday. I bought a shirt. So I pay money and the money and I give and I take the shirt. Generalmente, ¿qué hace cuando va a las tiendas?
Voy a comprar.
Ah, entonces, ¿cómo se dice comprar?
Ah,
come on. No, sí, sí, Ruth.
Mire.
It's a receiver.
Ay, no, comprar. ¿Cómo es?
Check the chat.
To buy.
Buy.
Buy. Ah, eso sería B-U-Y.
Yes. Bye.
Entonces solo esto voy a cambiar.
Yes.
Bye, voy a probar.
Ese es el verbo en presente.
Ay, no, teacher, es que ese volado. Eso del presente, ay, Dios mío. Ay, por fin, gracias, gracias. Hoy sí tengo todas mis tareas completas.
Ok. There you go.
Y cabal, digo, a mí me tiene que tocar cabal en la fecha para entregar esta cosa. Pero si le entendí.
Ah, ok, bien. Recuerde que en preguntas así, el verbo no se coloca en pasado, se coloca en presente. Ok, eso para futuras preguntas, ok. Recuerde, en la pregunta se escribe en presente el verbo. En la respuesta ya el verbo va en pasado. Ok, ya. Yeah. Esa es la forma.
Bye.
All right. Any other question, Ruth? ¿Alguna otra duda que pueda tener?
No, porque las otras ya las resolví. Las otras sí les entendí.
Nah. Ok. Very good. Muy bien. Entonces ya solo quedaríamos con lo de la discussion section, que voy a dar la indicación ahí para que usted pueda elaborar las preguntas que había mencionado. Ok.
Ah, bye.
Perfect. Entonces, nos vemos mañana, Ruth, ¿ok?
Hasta mañana, teacher. Gracias.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye.